Good morning. I am Dr. Othonos, and this is a series of e-learning lessons, international e-learning lessons, from the Homeopathic Academy in collaboration with the Marathon International Summer School and the Homeopathy Data Bank. This is the 18th lesson. We have already done some theoretical lessons. We have already talked about some of the chronic homeopathic constitutions. We have done Materia Medica. And now it's time to go on further and speak about probably the most important knowledge of all when it comes to homeopathy, the homeopathic case taking. It's the most important, but because it's what you do in clinical practice, you take the case. And because in homeopathy, taking the case gives the kind of treatment, selects the remedy that you will give, and the remedy does the job, that's why it's the most important part of all. Case taking. If you do an allopathic case taking, then you will end up in the conclusion of from what disease the patient suffers. That's the aim of the allopathic case taking, to end up deciding what kind of disease affects the patient. When you have done this and you have concluded what's the disease, then you go to the allopathic treatment and choose the remedies, the drugs that you will give. What about the homeopathic case taking? What is its aim? The aim of the homeopathic case taking is to end up what constitution affects the patient. So, allopathic case taking, homeopathic case taking. The aim is the disease. The aim is the constitution. That constitution that is dominant and affects the patient, because at a certain time we may have not only one, but two or three or four constitutions affecting the patient at that time, but only one of them is the most dominant one, and that's what we will prescribe the remedy that is similar to the most prevalent constitution. So, allopathic case taking, disease. Homeopathic case taking, constitution. When it comes to homeopathic case taking, we must decide what we call constitution. What is our aim? We have already talked about the several methods of homeopathic prescribing. What is the aim of the classical miasmatic constitutional homeopathy. And what is the aim of other mechanical methods, like repertorizing, computer prescribing, computer expert systems, and keynote prescribing, and other methods. Our aim is the prevalent constitution. And in order to reach to that point, we have to know the miasmatic profile, the prevalent constitution, other constitutions that affect the patient at that present time. We also focus on non-verbal data, on the psychological profile of the patient, and on the general physical characteristics. These two have to do with the state of clinical health. That is pathology phase A, state of clinical health. That's where we focus when we apply the classical miasmatic constitutional case taking. We focus on the miasmatic profile of the patient, on the prevalent constitution, other constitutions that affect the patient, non-verbal data, psychological profile, general physical characteristics, and all these concern the state of clinical health. They concern the individual. Not the patient in the because we don't focus on his symptoms, on his characteristics during the state of clinical health. Individual. We are interested in the individual. We are interested in John Brown. And when we talk about the individual, we are also interested about his relations, about his job, about the society that he lives in, about his intellectual patterns. About his opinions, about his intentions. Although we deal with all these things, our final aim is to find the prevalent constitution. But if we don't use all these fields of information, we will not end up safely on the prevalent constitution. What do we do with other methods? With other methods, it comes to allopathy, allopathic therapeutic system, we are interested only in the disease. And in order to decide the disease, we deal with symptoms, signs, and laboratory tests. Okay, when we come to the disease-oriented homeopathy, if it is homeopathy, my opinion is that this is not homeopathy. When we come to the disease-oriented homeopathy, we are interested again in the disease, that is, symptoms. And maybe signs. For example, we say he's got fever symptom, we will give belladonna or arsenic. For each patient we see with fever, we give belladonna. Or for each patient that we see that has fever, we will ask a few modalities of his fever. Is it a high fever, a low fever, a continuous, a remittent? Is it a fever that is more frequent at night, in the morning? Is it a frequent fever that is accompanied by perspiration or not? And then we say, give him arsenicum, give him aconitum. This is repertorizing. When we do repertorizing, before we go to repertorizing, we must also talk about the complex homeopathy, if it is homeopathy. My opinion is that it is not. Complex homeopathy focuses on the disease and violates the law of the one remedy, of the similimum, and says, you've got fever, you've got colitis, you've got arthritis. What are the most frequently used homeopathic remedies in arthritis? It is Ras toxicodendron, rhododendron, ledum, and so on. So I take all these 5, 10, 15 remedies and I give them as a remedy. Which is the similimum? We don't know. So, in complex homeopathy, we are also based on the disease. In repertorizing, where are we focused on? Most of the times, we focus on the symptoms, mainly on the physical symptoms. If we base some use also the mental symptoms, the psychological or mental symptoms. And this is the focus on the acute illness, acute illness. So, in repertorizing, either done by a computer, but with the help of a computer expert system, or done mechanically from the book, from the repertory, we focus on symptoms, that is, on acute illness. And most of the times we focus mostly on the physical symptoms and sometimes on the mental if they exist. So you have a patient, you don't have an individual, you have a patient with acute illness, and you focus mostly on the physical level and sometimes on the mental also. During the acute illness, symptoms, not characteristics. We have a patient with pneumonia, and we say, what are his main symptoms? Fever, secretion, coryza, cough, pain, chest, and so on. We take the modalities of the case according to time, space, temperature, and we do repertorizing. For each, we go to the repertory and see these symptoms that have these modalities to what constitutions does it refer to. But we focus on the acute illness. The patient during the pneumonia may have a characteristic picture or may not have. If it has a characteristic picture, for example, if it is an arsenicum or an aconitum, and it is very much afraid of death, we use also mental or psychological symptoms during the acute illness. Some homeopathic doctors also use the general physical characteristics during the chronic illness, that is, at pathology phase A, B, or C. The general physical characteristics, that is, they ask him, when you are not ill, usually, do you like sweet things? Do you have an aversion for fat? Are you cold or hot? Do you perspire a lot or not? Are your discharges offensive, your sweat, or not? These are general physical characteristics that concern the individual, the state of clinical health, the pathology phase A. Some add these to the previous. And some also add the mental characteristics of the individual during the chronic illness, during the state of clinical health. If you do repertorizing only on the physical symptoms, you are lost. If you add the mental symptoms, you are not so lost. But then, if you count your diagnosis only on this acute illness stage, then each time the patient comes to you, you will prescribe for his pneumonia, for his acute illness, you will prescribe for his acute arthritis, you will prescribed for his acute illness, but you will prescribe an acute constitution. This will send away the acute symptoms, will throw away the acute symptoms, you will cure the acute symptoms, you will cure the acute illness. You will not cure his chronic illness. You will not cure his chronic predispositions. You will cure this acute arthritis, but you will not cure his chronic predispositions that have to do with the musculoskeletal system. And you will not cure any other chronic predispositions that also exist. You will not cure his miasmatic influences. You will not cure his deepest constitutional influences. If you focus on the acute illness, you will cure the acute illness, but it will keep coming back again and again because you haven't cured his chronic predispositions. That's what Hahnemann was doing for 20 years. He was curing the acute illness again and again, but he realized that things came back again. There were relapses. That's why he talked about chronic illness and chronic predispositions and miasms, from which chronic predispositions come. Yet he hadn't had the time to develop a method of diagnosis and a materia medica that could serve to treat the patient for his chronic illness, to treat the individual, to treat the state of clinical health, to treat the pathology phase A. So, after Hahnemann, Kent and other students tried to cure the individual. Kent managed to define the picture of only a few chronic constitutions during the state of clinical health. Most of his materia medica and his repertory, nevertheless, dual and are focused on acute illness. And that's why the most usual method is repertorizing on acute illness. Later on, some talked about the general physical characteristics, and they added these to the homeopathic case taking. General physical characteristics concern the chronic state, the chronic illness, and also mental characteristics during the state of clinical health concern the chronic illness. In keynote prescribing, we do the same thing and we focus on the same things, but we try to find some keynotes in order to found our diagnosis. And the same thing is done by the computer expert systems. These are the mechanical methods of prescribing. Kent has talked also, and we can find that in the introduction to his repertory, to the sixth edition of his repertory. He talks about the mechanical method of prescribing and the artistic method of prescribing. Artistic. Well, And he says that artistic method is preferable, but it can only be carried out successfully by an experienced homeopathic doctor, and not by a doctor that is a new one. Nevertheless, he says that even if we apply the artistic method, we have also to do repertorizing. He called this the scientific method, the mechanical one, and he called this the artistic method. Well, I believe that art and science should go hand by hand. And art is the one that is higher, hierarchically. So, during the 30 years that I have practiced homeopathy, I developed a genuine artistic method, an advanced artistic method of prescribing, which I call classical miasmatic constitutional case taking. This method is in accordance with the homeopathic laws and in accordance to and it focuses on the individual at the state of clinical health. It focuses on chronic prescribing. It focuses on chronic illness. According to my opinion and to the opinion of homeopathy, of classical homeopathy, when we are clinically healthy according to allopathy, according to homeopathy, we are chronically ill. That is, we are under the influence of the miasms and the constitutions, of the chronic constitutions. So, we cannot be diagnosed with a disease, but we can be diagnosed that we are under the influence of a chronic illness, which is nothing else than the miasmatic and constitutional influences that a person, an individual, is under the influence of. So, in the artistic method, we deal mostly with characteristics. When the patient comes to us, what do we do in classical miasmatic constitutional homeopathy? We have a certain scheme that we follow, but when you progress and you are an experienced homeopathic doctor, that doesn't mean that you will always follow this scheme. What is this scheme? The patient comes to us and he may suffer from an acute illness. Or he may not suffer from an acute illness, but he has some chronic disease. Or many chronic diseases. If he has an acute illness, we take the symptoms and we do and we see his physical symptoms and the mental symptoms during the acute illness. We take the modalities, we do repertorizing, and we give him the acute remedy, the acute remedy that is similar to the acute constitution that affects him during the hours or days that this acute illness is at its peak. Then we go on and we have examined the patient. Now we will examine the individual. We say, okay, you will take this 1 millimum for your acute illness, let's say belladonna, for some hours or days, and then when this is over, I will give you the chronic remedy that suits, that is similar to your chronic illness, to you as an individual. At this stage, I have treated you as a patient. Now I treat you as an individual at the state of chronic illness. It's very important to discriminate between if you have a patient, if you have an acute illness, or if you have an individual, if you have a chronic illness. So, when the patient comes to us, the first thing to do is to take the allopathic history, allopathic case taking. That is, first of all, we ask him age, sex, height, weight, and so on, his personal data. Then we take the allopathic history, present diseases, past diseases, laboratory tests, and so on. When we finish with this, then we go to the homeopathic case taking, to the homeopathic history. The homeopathic history, in our case, classical miasmatic constitutional homeopathy, we proceed with the general physical characteristics of the patient. General physical characteristics. That is, are you cold or hot? Do you like this or that food? Do you have an aversion to this or that food? How do you like to sleep? And so on. Then we go to the mental characteristics. That is, irritability, introversy, extroversy, fears, and so on. His mental characteristics. Then we go to differential diagnosis. Differential diagnosis. And then to the final diagnosis. Nevertheless, during this procedure, some other information, some other data, very important data, come up. Non-verbal data. From what we see, that is, the way he is dressed, the way he expresses, what he says or what he doesn't say, his body structure, the way he behaves, all these are non-verbal data. and are very important if we know how to interpret them. Then we also decide what are the miasms that affect him and the prevalent miasm. Is it mostly psoric, psychotic, or syphilitic? Then, while talking about his mental characteristics, he may say that some events have happened, and these events in his life, past or present, have caused his physical illness to come out, or his mental illness. We are interested in how he interpreted these events and how they affect him. We can have great information about his miasmatic profile and his psychological profile from the way he acts during these events. We also have great information from his opinion about politics, his opinion about many things, and also, and this reveals us his intellectual patterns that he has in his brain. Opinions and intellectual patterns. These can help us decide his miasms and his constitution and the constitutional influences. His relations with other people, with his affair, with his family members, with friends, with the society. The relations are very important. They reveal us his miasmatic and constitutional profile. His sexual life also is important. So, we can have a great deal of information. Someone could say that if we deal with all this, then we will have a 3-hour case taken. That is not correct. From my clinical practice, applying this certain method, you need, if you are experienced, about 45 minutes in order to take the whole case, the allopathic information, explanations to the patient, to see his laboratory tests, to take the homeopathic case taking, to decide the remedy you will give, and to explain to the patient how to do the treatment. You need about 45 minutes. If you are not an experienced one, you may need 1 hour, 1 hour and a quarter. But during these 45 minutes or 1 hour, which is the first consultation and the most critical one, you've got a full picture, not only of the patient, not only of the constitutions that influence him, not only of the miasm that influence him, but also of the individual. You've got a full picture of John Brown. And you know his past, his present, and sometimes you can predict his future, both physically and psychologically, and both individually and as concerns his social life. If you focus with other methods on the disease and on the acute illness, you have a very poor picture that has to do with the patient, the acute patient, not with the individual. Why know the individual? Because if you know the individual, you go deeper. You go to his chronic state, and then you choose a remedy that suits his chronic state, that suits the individual, and that's why you can cure the chronic predispositions. And you can lessen the miasmatic and constitutional influences. While if you focus on the acute illness, then you treat the acute illness or certain specific symptoms, and then you can only cure the most the acute illness. You don't cure the chronic illness. You don't cure the miasmatic influences. You don't cure the constitutional influences. You don't cure the individual. So you have only results that are not temporary, that are not deep. While with the classical miasmatic constitutional case taking and chronic prescribing, you have deep and permanent results, if possible, if the patient is not suffering from a progressed state of illness. Now, let's go on to see how this is carried out. Let's take the first step. The patient comes to you. The general data. What we are interested in? We are interested in his general data because these will give us the background of the patient. What are these general data? Sex, male or female? You don't ask it, you see it. Height and weight. I will tell you why we are interested in this. Age. Profession. Financial and social status. Personal status, married, single, divorced, widow or widower, family, children, is he living alone, does he have a great family with 10 children, 1 children, no children? These are important to give us a background of the individual. The individual is not living alone. He lives with other people in a certain society. Even the nationality and the country of origin where he lived are important. Even his religion religious beliefs are important. We will see why. This is his background. Why is it important? The sex, male or female. There are certain constitutions that are prevalently male or prevalently female, or mostly male or female. That's important. Age. There are other constitutions prevailing, chronic constitutions, prevailing in a fetus or in an early childhood, other in the puberty, and other in adults or very old people. For example, you can